I'm Steve Chevron, a portfolio manager at Federated Investors.
Why do you believe we're in the midst of another industrial revolution?
Look, there's clearly a pickup in technological progress across the spectrum, from AI to automation, advanced robotics, the Internet of Things, blockchain, 3D printing, and even biotech. What makes this an industrial revolution and not simply just a pickup in technology is it's having a real profound impact on the overall economy. So you see this in people moving back into cities, the rise of small business. You can also see it in our politics being driven to a little bit more extremes. These are classic features of an industrial revolution. And while there's disruption, what we think is particularly interesting and an opportunity here is it's driving the economy to a more efficient place. So you have large companies that are focusing on, increasingly, on making high volume, low priced, automated good for the masses. And you have an emerging class of craft companies who are filling a niche, and they're coming in making low volume, higher priced, more specific goods, more customized good for the high end. When you put that together, it makes the economy more efficient. And what we think it allows for investors is an economy that produces higher growth, higher earnings, higher overall productivity, and all of that with less inflationary pressures because there's an endless assault on price and cost. That is a really exciting time for corporate earnings.
How do millennials fit into this landscape?
So alongside of what's going on the digital revolution side, you have a rise of a new generation. So there's 92 million millennials, which is 15 million more than there ever were baby boomers. So this is the largest generation in our history that's coming of age. And this generation is actually the United States' greatest natural resource because a lot of other major economies don't have a young and up-and-coming population. Now, there's a lot of myths about these folks, and everyone likes to dislike the millennials, but the truth is this group has less than average debt, an emerging wealth base, and a higher and higher appetite for equities as they go from their early years of life, that kind of college to 30, where they're paying down debt, funding short-term goals. When they hit the magic age of 30, what all of a sudden starts to happen is they form families, they're now funding education, they're catching up on retirement, and there's an increased appetite for equities because they need higher returns. So what we have is an upward pressure on earnings in the economy from the digital revolution, an upward appetite for equities from this emerging generation, and when you put those two things together, you have the makings of a secular bull market in the long run.